Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little ridiculous.
Good boy.
Play all the hits. Left Toronto Maple Leafs. Let me finish. How am I supposed to go to bed after watching that?
I'm quite hyped. With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Well, hello there. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Steve Dangle here, and welcome to my YouTube channel and Leafs fan reaction. LFR. Leafs win 4-3 in overtime over the Dallas Stars. Now, this is going to be a very rare one-taker. This is game, 71 on the season? I don't do a lot of one-takers. It's a lot of jump cuts and stuff like that, and producer Drew is going to help me with that. But tonight, we got to do a one-taker. I am shooting this at 1:23 in the morning because I was downtown. A bunch of people were like, were you dead? Are you dead? During the game because I wasn't tweeting during it. First of all, it's nice to put the phone down every now and then. And second of all, that's what I was up to. I was with some friends and not on my phone. And I was talking to them and, you know, just having a look at the game and everything. Last night, I was at the Conn Smythe Gala, producer Drew. Can we get a little commotion for the suit? I bought a suit because I didn't want to be ignored. The Conn Smythe Gala is to benefit Easter Seals. It's a charity that helps out kids with physical disabilities. Stop me if you've heard that before. It's a charity that I talk about all the time. They invited me to help with the auction, the silent auction. I won an item in the auction, actually. And I'm going to talk about that on tomorrow's podcast. I think you'll want to know what I won. There's a certain fan base out there will want to know what I ended up winning. But there's a photo, a group photo with all the ambassadors. You'll notice superfan Nav Bhatia from the Raptors. I'm standing in between Eric Lindros and Joe Carter. That's ridiculous and preposterous and silly. And also, I'm the only one who got the memo about dressed like a peacock, apparently, literally like the shade of blue that a peacock is. Anyway, so I've had a couple days and tomorrow's podcast is going to be a battle. Speaking of battle, Austin Matthews continues to fight his battle against not scoring goals. Holy cow. Dude, 56! 56! That's unbelievable. That's stupendous. That's preposterous. You all saw the game. You know what happened, but let's go through it. Rapid fire anyway. William Nylander comes in the first period, rips that thing off the post so hard that a bunch of the Stars were like, no, it didn't happen. And that might have worked before replay, but since we have that, it's a goal. Leafs have a defensive breakdown. There's a funny bounce. Tyler Seguin evens it up. We go to the second period. And by the way, in the second period and also in the first period and then later the third period in overtime, this game was special in terms of commentary because it was called by, I'm going to call him my Sportsnet colleague, even though like I'm never on the TV side, like never. But Harnarayan Singh got to call this game for Sportsnet along with Gary Galley and Sean McKenzie. Harnarayan, if you listen to his appearance on the podcast that we did, you might forget it because it was one of the remote episodes that we did during COVID. But his was one of my favorite episodes to do from my house, and it sort of helped me forget the hellscape that we were in at the time. So, second period goes by. The Leafs are pulling further and further and further away from the Dallas Stars. Even though they're wearing a jersey that you can literally see from space, the Leafs are kicking the Stars up and down the ice in their own building, which I was shocked by. It's not that I don't have faith in the Leafs. It's not that I didn't think they would respond well to blowing a 5-1 lead against the Florida Panthers last game. It's that Dallas really needs these points, and they're a good team who has home ice advantage. You don't expect the Leafs to be tripling the home team in shots, even if that team was in last place. So, end of the second, Leafs power play, Austin Matthews, shades of, do you remember that goal he scored against Vegas? That 2-1 overtime game that John Tavares won? It was in Toronto. Malcolm Subban had that ridiculous game from Vegas. Matthews had like the frustrated rage in that goal. Why won't this stupid thing go in? And then it did. reminded me of that goal. And historic. Yes, historic. I saw some people arguing about that. He broke the single season goals record for a hockey team that has been around for over 100 years. Yes, it is at very least part of Leafs history, for crying out loud. His 55th of the season puts the Leafs up 2-1. After Matthews makes history, we go into intermission. All right. Leafs blow a lead last game, fairly large lead. Now they got to defend it in the third. And unfortunately, they can't. Listen, I'm not going to make producer Drew do a ton of this with the screenshots, but can we just... I saw some people getting on Jack Campbell for this. How is this Jack Campbell's fault? I'm going to go with it's not on account of covered John Klingberg. Look at that jersey. You can't not look at that jersey. Look at that retina burner. Get in there and get on it. A few minutes later, Michael Bunting just whips it across the blue line with a hope and a prayer. Mitch Marner's looking around for a dance partner. Who do I give it to? It looks like he's going to give it to Matthews for the one-timer, but a few feet in front of him is also left-handed Morgan Rielly, who blasts it on with a one-timer of his own. Sort of sneaky, stealthy play there. I really like it. Morgan Rielly has really picked his moments to jump up in the play recently. That's his 10th of the season. Double digits. The Leafs have the lead once again. Can they defend it? No is once again the answer. Roope Hintz is in front of the net. John Tavares is trying to fend him off. Not a defender in sight, except for TJ Brody, who is trying to fend off Joe Pavelski, who tips in a shot that is going well wide. And again, you can look at Jack Campbell's numbers and go, oh gosh, it's below 900. What is he supposed to do there? He cannot see the thing on the second goal, and this is Joe Pavelski doing what Joe Pavelski does. If it was so easy to stop Joe Pavelski from doing what Joe Pavelski does, then goalies and defenders would do it, but they can't. So, game is tied. It goes to overtime. Folks, this guy is special. This guy, let me tell you something. Let's get through the goal first. Matthews flies around the entire Dallas Stars, and Joe Pavelski is chasing after him, and he's got this look of, well, I'm not going to catch him, but the next guy will, surely. And the next guy was Tyler Seguin, and he sort of gave Matthews a glance like, oh, is this my job? And oh, yeah, it is, but again, easier said than done. Matthews swoops across, hooks it in, beats Wedgwood, mugs to the crowd. Are you not entertained? And the answer is, I don't think any player has ever in the history of the Toronto Maple Leafs been more entertaining. I don't think any player in the history of the Toronto Maple Leafs has ever been more dominant. And we know no player in the history of the Toronto Maple Leafs has ever been a better goal scorer in a single season. Not only does Auston Matthews have 56 goals already on this season, not only has he already surpassed 250 for his career, even though he's only 24, not only does Auston Matthews only have a few goals left with 11 games remaining, a few goals left to hit 60, not only does Matthews have a chance at 70 this season. I don't remember where I was going with the not only. Well, so much for the one-taker. Oh, right! Matthews has 49 goals in his last 49 games, which sets up Saturday, Leafs hosting the Habs, the Montreal Canadiens. And Matthews has an opportunity to not just extend his record-breaking season for the Toronto Maple Leafs, but he could score 50 goals in 50 games. Guys, one day you're going to tell your kids that you watched Auston Matthews play on the Leafs in his prime. I know I'm going to be talking to Leo, because Leo's going to be getting into hockey when Matthews is a graybeard. On this team still, by the way. No, he's not going to Arizona. He's going to be on this team still. And Leo's going to be like, man, I looked at his numbers, and this old guy, I can't believe how good it says he was. Son, I got to see him play in person. Son, I got to see mid-20s Auston Matthews play in person. How many games has Auston Matthews already generated for Leaf fans where they would be able to say, I was there. I was there when he scored 4 goals in his first ever game. I was there when he had that spinorama pass to Mitch Marner in the Next Generation game against the Carolina Hurricanes. I was there in Dallas when he scored that amazing overtime winner after setting the new single-season record for goals in a season for the Toronto Maple Leafs. You are witnessing Toronto Maple Leafs history. No one has ever been better than this cat. Questions. Is Austin Matthews the gloat? So that stands for greatest Leaf of all time. I feel like I should specify. Nick, I hate that term. So no one is the gloat. Okay, fine. I suppose if anyone is, it's him. But you're not allowed to gloat, because if you gloat in hockey, that means people are allowed to punch you in the face. That's what I learned this week. Original Sin 33 says, and I gotta say they're correct. As a non-Leafs fan who bet on the Leafs, how do you do this every night? You stepped into the lion's den, did you? I don't know. I'm still alive. You know, I think I look pretty good for my age. By the way, I'm 17. Cheering for a team that wins every season and holds every lead would be boring. And this isn't a question, but I like this from Adil. Ice Singh, H-N-I-C, that's Harnarayan Singh, ended the game with Wajiwa, which loosely translates to wow. He's so good on the broadcast. I 100% agree. I hope he gets to do lots more Leaf games, and he's going to get to do lots more Leaf games. The thing about Harnarayan is he's undeniable. All we got to do is wait for him to get the opportunity. He's going to be doing so many games, and they're going to be electric. I can't wait. So, ladies and gentlemen, so much for the one taker. It's only a several taker, but that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. Saturday could be another part of Leafs history.